4 days we have been doing a lot of meditation and a lot of messages. This will be our final message and final meditation. I request Sri Ashok Kumar Garu to give an introduction to us.
Subhash Bhattacharya ki, Prasanna Venkatacharya Chaturvedi gari ki, మీ అందరికీ నమస్కారాలు. చతుర్వేది స్వామి గారు అనేక శాస్త్రాల్లో అనేక భాషల్లో అనర్గళంగా మనకి విషయాలు చెప్తారు. వారి గురించి ఎంత చెప్పినా తక్కువే. ఇప్పుడు మరియు అతి కష్టం మీద ఇక్కడికి రావటం జరిగింది. చాలా ఇబ్బంది పడ్డారు ట్రాఫిక్లో. దాంట్లో ఈ 3 గంటల ముందు రావాల్సింది, తర్వాత వచ్చారు. ట్రాఫిక్ డిస్టెన్స్ కొంచెం అది తెలవక అట్లా అయిపోయింది. తర్వాత వారు ఎన్నో శాస్త్రాల గురించి తెలిసిన వారని నాకు చెప్పారు, తెలుసుకున్నవారు. అయితే నేను కొన్ని విషయాలు వారు సభల్లో చెప్తున్నది విన్నాను. కొన్ని ఇంజనీరింగ్ విషయం, తర్వాత శాస్త్ర పరిజ్ఞానం, ఆత్మజ్ఞానం విషయంలోనూ వారు ఇక్కడ చెప్పవలసిందిగా కోరుతూ ఈ అవకాశం నాకు ఇచ్చినందుకు మీ అందరికీ, పత్రికారికి, వారికి అందరికీ కృతజ్ఞత.
శ్రీమతి రామానుజాయ నమః. ఇట్ ఈస్ వండర్ఫుల్ అకేషన్ వెరీన్ బై వీఆర్ సీయింగ్ ద రెస్ప్లెండెంట్ మూన్ ఆన్ ద స్కై యాజ్ వెల్ యాజ్ ద ఇన్బిల్ట్ రేడియేషన్ ఆఫ్ అవర్ eternal and persistent pursuit on the truth, the reality, infinity and eternity. It should also be attuned in par excellence with the resplendence of the external tools of luster such as sun, moon and stars. It is known as antar jyoti, the internal effulgence. Now let me come to the point of meditation. And as it has been initiated by various scholars pertaining to various schools of yogic thought, it has been deepened by so many people, simplified by so many people, so many demonstrators, accomplishers, they have defined yoga in various dimensional approaches. And there are 6 golden rules of yoga, which I want to put in a process of a brevity without losing its sense of gravity and depth. The primary rule is, human being, whenever he is subjected to a bondage, he is subjected to the process of both exhaustion of his resources and as well as the process of exploration of the resources and imbibition of the same. So these resources are his physical nourishment, his mental nourishment, intellectual and spiritual nourishment. As he is in bondage, it is dependent on internal and external factors. And there are 2 main processes. Whenever a person's physical grasp or tangible nourishment or requirement is subjected to imbalance in equilibrium, there is a process of imbibition of the nutrients so as to keep it in ease. Likewise, if the internal subtler tools, if they are lacking of resources, That is also a subtler process by which the inner resources are balanced. So the outer balancing technology by which a person's gross, tangible or physical nutrition or resource management is governed is known as medication, and the inner requirement is balanced by meditation. This is the first explanation of the golden rules of meditation. And meditation, you know that it has lot of definitions. I want to put it as very practical, simple and easily accessible to all. Different levels of meditations are there. The simplified version of the definition of meditation is, it must have three qualities: uninterrupted, potential, directed force towards a goal is known as meditation. The process by which the thought rays are directed, it must be having a direction. If it has random movement, it is no more a meditation. Second thing, it must be potential. If it is imbecile, if it is just a desire, if it is just your wish, if it is just your dream, which has not been potentialized by courage, commitment, confidence, care and nourishment by spiritual authorization, then that is just a dream, daydream or an air castle. So it must have potentiality, and it must be lack of interruption. Interruption from internal, external, circumstantial, physical, intellectual, moral, ethical, social, varieties of issues are there. So it must be uninterrupted, even if it is for a limited frame time, even though incessantly it may be impossible. A certain time frame based on a certain goal, based on a particular token and target of achievement, if it is uninterrupted, potentialized and targeted with a directive principle, that voltage is known as meditation. That is the second rule. The third thing what we want to say here is, you know that there are questions inside our mind. We want to classify about the third rule. It is known as the principle of qualitative and quantitative potential study of the mind. You are having a doubt. It is clarified by a person, and it has also come out of the mind of the same person. A person is clarifying a doubt, and that person's doubt or the skeptic emanation is coming from mind of a person, and also the same mental status of a different person, it evinces the clarification. So both are coming from the same level of human beings, but having some inner, certainly you are getting curiosity by which you are asking questions. It is known as Purvapaksha and Siddhanta, prima facie and solution, Akshepa Samadhana, repudiation and vindication, Shanka Pariharana, skepticism and clarification. So all of these things, getting into a problem and getting a solution, it comes from the same mind in different levels. So that's why we used to say, whenever you are in self-search, if you are there in a primeval search or a peripheral search, you will get lot of questions, puzzles and riddles. If you go inside your inner self, you will get the same answers which you are getting from the external sources within yourself. So meditation is a process of inner pursuit by means of which whatever the problems, whatever the basic things, rudimentary predicaments that we are experiencing in various walks of life, in a peripheral approach, the same thing comes as the form of the nectar of solution if it is done with a deeper breath. That is the third rule of meditation, which deals with self-search. This self-search is entirely different from the intellectual search of the Western scientific school. Western scientific school is based on observations, experimentation and verification. Wherever your intellect, as it is dependent on sources of knowledge, it requires experimentation, it requires observation, it requires verification, then formation of a tenet which frames the basic rudimentary principles of science and application of technology. So as intellect is dependent, as intellect is incomplete, as intellect is a derivative, the intellectual search of science, it requires dependence on external tools which I have now enumerated. Whereas self-search, as self is totally free from the blemish of nescience, oblivion and various other demarcations, as self is the spirit and spark of the ultimate reality and infinity of the universe, it is totally immaculate and it clears you from all the vidyate hrithaya granthi, chidyante sarva samshayaha, kshiyante chasya karmani, tasmin drishte paravare. That puts an eternal solution, eternal full stop to all of the problems, resulting in inexhaustible and final bliss. So this is the third rule by which the self-search, in deeper sensation, it gives you solutions. So you are having solutions inbuilt, for which you need a tool such as Shastra, which is an oral or verbal tool, or a shishta, a mobile tool in the form of a preceptor, in form of a practice, in form of certain rules which we have to observe through penance and austerity. So all of these external tools are to reconsider your own self-evaluative study of your introspective truth. So this is the third rule in which you know everything and you have to go deeper and you have to get the resources from external support and authorities. That is the third thing. The fourth major rule, it is meditation. What is the fruit of meditation? Meditation can give anything. The immediate benefit or the most trivial benefit of meditation is contentment. Contentment. It is not producing you all rejoiceable entities that you are dreaming of. It is not making you hyper-prudential. It is not only a system of accomplishment. Basically, it starts with contentment. Even if you don't get, even if it is adverse, the process of contentment is the initial boon of meditation. So starting from implanting satisfaction inside a small heart, till implanting global harmony, even reaching the liberation in eternal bliss, the journey of the benefits of the meditation goes. It is an endless voyage. It starts with a single person's contentment and society's refinement, and it broadens to the enlightenment by which a person reaches the spiritual realm, which is known as the salvation or emancipation. These are all the benefits of meditation. Then there is a fourth principle. Now we are coming to the fifth principle. What is meditation? What is the level of meditation? Generally, we think it as meditation means you have to sit, close your eyes and think of something. It is not just like that. Meditation is a discipline, and the discipline is multifaceted, in which sitting and then closing your eyes or chanting something is one among the rules of the discipline. So I want to say something. It is a very wonderful golden principle of meditation. Whenever you are born in the world, you are born deficit. We have deficiencies and efficiencies. We have allergy, energy and synergies within ourselves. Likewise, we have to move with people who are distinct from us, who are distinguishable from us, who are different from us, who are despicable and who are deplorable, who are downtrodden. We have to move with a lot of people. So we have to get that art of getting security, fraternity and united prosperity or integral prosperity. Wherever there are evil elements, first you must, before converting them or before making them corrigible or tameable, you must be made secure that you will not be implanted anything from their evil prince. So that is known as security. The second thing is fraternity. We have to move with them, and wherever there are elements of higher preposition, there we have to charge ourselves. And wherever people who are inferior to us, we have to charge them in turn. So meditation is a process of establishing global relationship which totally unravels the person's inner mystery, as well as it levels the person's imbalances in the society. Wherever there are greater sources, you imbibe knowledge and power. Wherever there are lower surfaces, there you need not show any prejudice, hatredness or adversity. There you can show your love, sympathy. So with a clemential touch, you are approaching the inferiors, and with a sense of subservience, you are observing your obeisances towards your greater people, by which you are qualifying the whole world. So meditation is a process of leveling the universal disparities. That is the fifth golden rule. And we are having no doubt lot of things about meditation. There are some small fragments of meditation which we have even misconceived as meditation. So somebody may be observing something very closely. So we are thinking that he is meditating. That is attention. You know that there are lot of qualitative and quantitative nomenclatures. For example, gram, kg, ton, these things are quantitative nomenclatures. Likewise, qualitative nomenclatures are also there. Just a stone is there, marble is there, granite is there, coal is there, lignite is there. Lot of products are there from the same destructive or the various types of distillations from the same products as byproducts are as different. Various structures observed from the same emanation center. So these things are the nomenclatures of the same thing, but with different quality and quantities. Likewise, whenever you move for your thing with aspiration, whenever you move for your thing, you exhibit your zeal to know that. That is known as attention. And the second thing is known as concentration. Concentration is often misconceived as meditation. Most of the people, they consider that concentration as meditation, or meditation even, some people they used to interpret it as concentration. So attention is just showing your proclivity, your mental inclination towards the thing.